Hey all listeners, this is the Legion Comes With Xenoxis. We're continuing on here in Siege of Orgrimmar. I mean, I never saw the full thing here. Oh, you can do the bopping flaps here. The graphical glitch happened there again. I mean, it was a really long time since it happened last time, so I'm not, you know, that worried. Yeah. Did I just hear in the bottom? Oh, Rams is from. Actually, I want to hear the music. Is there actually? I can't even tell what the music is. Chilling in a bar and I'm just like, it's hard to tell what this is because like this like a weird sound that you hear when like you're recording with this, like you hear like as you hear the microphone, but you know, like it's hard to hear what music it is. It sounds like barons, like an old school thing. Increase the number of ammo, I mean, it's worth it. Rams the wrong light. That's good music. Okay, let's actually bring it down a bit here. Let's bring this down a bit here. They're forcing them to dance. Can't go up there even. Oh no. Like a dance scene. That's probably where they got the idea to make the whole dancing thing. I never got to enjoy that. Like, I was so pissed off at missing it. Because it was only for a day, the whole dancing in the, you know, in the auction house. And it's a bit stupid that there have been several festivals, like the Great Nomagon Run was only one day. You know, like, it's just like, why is to have that, you know? Like, it's really hard to play on very, very specific days, and then if you miss something, you know, like when is the next time the thing is gonna be at the place. And hopefully it won't be used once a year. It might be once a year, actually. If that's the case, then that's gonna be really, really bad. Yeah, auction house dance party is just during that day. It's only in July. Like why, man? Why, man? Like, I never got to do that part of the thing, and I wanted to dance, you know, make a sexy Draenei transmog, you know, and do tailspin and then knock off all the kitchenwares. Yeah, okay, she probably has a key. Wait, PvP? Why can't I enable PvP? Huh? Oh yeah, you can't do that in raid because that would be a way to... Because then you could have like FC. Yeah, but I don't think I can get more keys than one. But can you go inside where Garrus used to visit?
The Warchief ignored my counsel. I discovered he was building a compound beneath the caverns of Rangefire. Thrall and Sauron have already gone down below. Go with caution. Hellscream has been assembling an arsenal down there. Goblin mercenaries, Pandaren artifacts, and some sort of darkness.
I love his voice acting, actually. I think it was a big part of when he found Krieg, but wasn't I think the one that was supposed to be blind? No. It's the Rektar that's supposed to be blind. It's weird though that the shaman that they did for Heroes of the Storm was Rhaegar. I mean, I guess it's because Palutena and Rhaegar, you know, and stuff that we heard. But I mean, like, Rektar just, you know, like... Well, what I'm hoping for is that there are going to be certain characters that they add, like... Tears of the Storm, and it won't just be a color swap of something, like, for example, like... For certain classes, I want to have, like, the male version of a certain classes from Diablo 3, for example. Like, for example, I would like to have the female monk, for example, because I prefer the female one of Karasim. And then maybe instead of being a support, that could maybe be an assassin or a tank. You know, and stuff that, and that's something, you know, that they could do. But wait, can you skip those bosses then? Can you skip the Dark Shaman? That's the question. I don't know how long I could record, if I could record, like... I'm guessing you cannot attack these. Oh, you can, okay. That's weird. I mean, the peon hasn't done anything, but, you know, it's not good to leave them alive. It's better to put them out of their misery, pretty much. Okay, you can... I'm guessing they won't allow you in here. No invisible walls. Oh, you can almost go over here. It looks like you can. Maybe? No, okay. That's curious. It looks like you could go there, but nope. Very clever. I mean, it looks completely open, like you should be able to go here, but... You cannot, so I'm guessing that gate, you have to go to the gate. I'm just gonna check the other side here. And we're recording really late now and stuff. Why do they keep talking about that key? There are no more keys. There's armor here, yeah. But it's really weird, Peninsula, I need to really take a dump really badly now. I'm feeling it in the stomach now. My stomach is getting really, really, you know. Because, you know, I've talked about this before, like, if people remember from the old channel, you know, I'm still pissed off about, you know, having to delete the old channel, you know, because it was mostly because I did a mistake and named a video wrong, that I named a video the previous year. Like, the thing that ruined it was that I was really stressed out at the end of last year. I did like a game of the year 2016 video, and I did a YouTuber of the year 2016 video. After I done those, I got pretty burnt out, so then I had another video planned because I was following a schedule then. And on that day, I just got so stressed out that I couldn't upload a video until very late that day, and then I uploaded videos. I did because I had recorded a video then when I was eating some chips, that I was reviewing some chips, and there was nothing offensive in the video, I didn't swear or anything. I was just reviewing a brand of chips, right? But then when I uploaded it, what I didn't notice was that I called the video 2016 during 2017. And apparently YouTube must have noticed that back in 2016 I must have had a video called something like January Xenoxis Show 2016 or something like that, and then because this had the same thing in the title, like Xenoxis Show blah 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 of this date, and even if I called it something extra like Chips Review and stuff like that, and the thing is, if a human would have checked the video out, they would have noticed it's not the same video as that one. But because of humans not checking in, it's just being a bot means that. So I didn't even know that when I had uploaded the video, I didn't even check that the video had gotten moved. And then later on, before going to bed, then like in the early morning, and then I did like, I went and checked, and then I noticed that the videos had been removed. And I was like, huh, you know, I'm gonna try and upload them again, you know, and stuff like that. because I thought maybe there's something wrong, you know, and my, had to upload it again just to see, and then it fell again, you know, it fell again, they got removed again, and I thought, okay, maybe it's just because the tags and the information in the video, so I didn't know description, I didn't know tags, because back then I actually used to have tags in the description, and that's not allowed apparently now, so it might have been because of that, but then I had to upload the video again with the same video again that got removed, or the several videos that got removed. I had to upload it again, and I still didn't change the name of the video because I didn't notice that it was still called 2016 instead of 2017. So, and I had removed like all the description or tags, but if you try and upload a video that's been blocked once, it's going to be automatically blocked by YouTube again, no matter what you do with the video, which is completely bullshit. And then use like having to delete a channel that had over 3,000 videos. And we had been doing YouTube almost since the very start, like I'm one of the oldest YouTubers on YouTube, you know. Yes, there are other YouTubers that are earlier, but still, I mean, like, I did YouTube for such a long time, and then used to lose everything like that, and then that new subs, and that maybe some of my old subscribers went to those friends' channels that are called Xenoxis, that probably they might be fooled that they think that that's me when it's not, you know, and stuff like that, and it's just, like, so weird. But yeah. And it was just really frustrating for me, you know, and stuff that stinks about the hair. Okay.
I need to get closer.
And pop the cooldown here. And I'm guessing there would be an achievement for not rescue raiders. Nice! Isn't that part of the set? Yes, it is. I have two parts of the set now. I mean, yes, I can understand them when they made it look like a shaman, like, and stuff like that, but it's still weird. Oh no, now I know what it's meant to be. It's meant to be kind of like a barbarian thing. Wasn't there a title for doing it on normal? I know why I need to do it in Havoc then, right, to get a title for Siege of Orgrimmar. Wish that said a thing. Or you need to do it on Mythic difficulty. But I'm guessing Mythic would be pretty easy one. If you have like a small guild group, you probably don't need a lot of people, but I mean the more people you have the better. Like the weird thing is that I'm doing worse on like my Paladin, because my Paladin is lacking a lot of haste and stuff, so yeah. And I'm gonna stop now and start